Na tusiwe nchi ya kulalamika peke yake, kwa sababu mimi nina uhuru ya kusema chochote mimi nataka kusema. Huwezi kufunga mdomo yangu. Jana nimeongea hapa Taita Taveta, naona wengine wananirukia, oh, Junet kwani bana mdomo ni yangu. Siasa ni yangu. Wakati tuliingia wamama vile wanavaa, waliambi wamama walisema my dress my choice. Mimi pia nasema my politics my choice. Huwezi kunilazimisha vile mimi nataka kwenda.
Ya mwisho, Your Excellency, mambo ya kuunganisha Wakenya. Lazima Wakenya waungane. Kuna wengine pale, mimi natoka huko Migori na huko Nyanza, kazi yao ilikuwa kufungia sisi nje tu. Sisi hawezi kubali hiyo. Hatuwezi kubali kufungiwa nje, kwa sababu sisi pia ni walipa ushuru kama wengine. Lazima tupate haki yetu. Sasa mtu anakuja hapa anasema, oh, shareholders, nyinyi hawezi kuwa hapa. Si tulinyorosha hai? Si muliona vile tulinyorosha hai? Na mtu yoyote ambaye ataleta ujinga kama hiyo, wembe ni ule huu.
I now understand very well the real reason as to why Raila Odinga will never ever abandon both Junet Mohamed and Ali Hassan Joho. I mean, just have a look at their political history together. You will agree with me that Junet Mohamed and Ali Hassan Joho have been with Raila Odinga for quite a very long period of time. So it is because both Joho and Junet Mohamed are the most loyal politicians. They are the most loyal leaders to Raila Odinga compared to other ODM party leaders. These two leaders here, Joho and Junet Mohamed, they are very much ready to listen to Raila Odinga. They are ready to follow Raila Odinga always. Where Raila Odinga goes, they are ready to follow Raila Odinga. Whatever decision that Raila Odinga makes, they will never ever betray Raila Amolo Odinga. And that is why in the previous 2022 general elections, both Junet Mohamed and Ali Hassan Joho delivered a total of over 6.9 million votes to Raila Odinga. I have seen leaders in ODM, leaders who have made it. They have been so successful. They have achieved a lot in Raila Odinga's ODM party. But currently, these leaders here, a very good example is Babu Owino, the Embakasi East member of the National Assembly, and also the ODM party secretary general, Edwin Sifuna himself. These leaders and more others are the ones who are currently opposing, in fact, publicly opposing Raila Odinga's decision to support the broad-based government with President William Ruto. Have you ever seen Junet Mohamed and Ali Hassan Joho opposing Raila Odinga? Of course no. Okay, look, so let me go straight into the point, because I don't want to waste your time with very long stories. Just recently, Raila Odinga made a decision to support President William Ruto. And let me just say that Raila Odinga made the best decision to support William Ruto, because I must congratulate Raila Odinga on that decision. It was not easy. But Raila Odinga accepted to work with William Ruto. That is why William Ruto and his allies must never ever take Raila Odinga's support for granted. President William Ruto also, on the other side, made the right decision, politically speaking, by approaching Raila Odinga and ODM to form the broad-based government ahead of the 2027 elections. Otherwise, without Raila Odinga, President William Ruto currently would be in a very, very deep trouble ahead of the 2027 elections. So Raila Odinga has saved President William Ruto in so many political issues that we all understand. But after Raila Odinga's decision to support President William Ruto and the broad-based government ahead of the 2027 elections, Ali Hassan Joho and Junet Mohammed are now emerging as the vocal defenders of President William Ruto. Meaning, Raila Odinga allowed both Junet Mohammed and Ali Hassan Joho to be appointed, to be assigned some duties in President William Ruto's government. Both Junet Mohammed and Ali Hassan Joho are publicly defending President William Ruto's government. Just the same way Raila Odinga also has been defending President William Ruto's projects. Just the other day, you saw how Raila Odinga strongly defended the Adani deals. Raila Odinga said that Adani ni mweupe kama pamba. Adani is as white as cotton. So I want you to watch, and I also want you to listen very keenly to this particular video here. This shocking video of Junet Mohammed. What he is saying here while defending President William Ruto publicly. I'll still do another video, a separate one, about Ali Hassan Joho. But in this video, I'm so interested in Junet Mohammed, because there's something special that I'll also tell you why Junet Mohammed is defending William Ruto that way. But before I play for you this video here, just a quick reminder, if you are joining me for the first time, if you are listening to me and you haven't subscribed to this channel, I want you to take only 1 second or two and hit the subscribe button down below so that the next time I produce a video like this one, YouTube will automatically send you the notification. It means that you will not miss even a single video that I post on this channel. You can also give this video a like, so that YouTube can automatically recommend this video in particular and this channel to reach out to more people. That is the only way we can improve this channel to grow. So to my returning subscribers, to the new members who are joining me for the first time, thank you so much. I don't take the support for granted. So follow this analysis to the end, because I'll be very brief and you will learn a lot of things. So just listen to this video.
Juzi muliona wale wako Nairobi. Airport yetu iko mbaya sana. Imeharibika. Waekelezaji wametoka nje kuja kusaidia sisi kujenga hiyo airport. Rais akasema kama wananchi wamekataa tumewacha. Sasa wale walikuwa wanapiga kelele, wapi maoni yenu ambaye kwa sababu airport lazima itengenezwe. Nchi hapa jirani yenu Tanzania wanafanya ni hiyo mwekelezaji kwa hiyo airport yao. Hawa ni wazimu. Tanzania ni wazimu. Kichwa imeruka hawa. Sasa lazima tutafute njia ya kusaidiana.
Inchi ilikuwa katika hali ngumu. Your Excellency, when you took over. Deni zilikuwa nyingi. Mambo ilikuwa mazito. Watu ya upinzani kama sisi tulikuwa tunangojea. Na tumeterejea kwa muda mrefu paka sasa. After, imekuwa after broadband sasa. Ikachelewa. Ya kwamba mutashindwa kulipa hii deni. When are you going to default? Not if we knew this was they are going to default. When they default, sasa tuko na hawa, bega kwa bega. Tuambia, si wameshindwa na kasi. Sasa, Mheshimiwa Rais, congratulations. Umejikakamua, paka leo. Naona mambo inaenda hivi hivi tu. Mzuri kabisa. So, sisi.
You have heard Junet Mohammed very well. What can you say about Junet Mohammed? How exactly can you describe Honorable Junet Mohammed after listening to him very keenly? Why do you think Junet Mohammed all of a sudden he is defending William Ruto that way? There are only 2 to 3 reasons behind this. Of course, Junet Mohammed is not defending President William Ruto just because of Raila Odinga. First of all, it is because of Junet Mohammed's political interest. That is why he is defending William Ruto. Because politics is all about interest. The personal interest of Junet Mohammed to President William Ruto. Number one, Junet Mohammed is defending President William Ruto because he is seeking to be appointed by President William Ruto in William Ruto's government. In the government position, and especially as the cabinet secretary. Now, the media, the Nation e-paper, recently made a shocking announcement about the cabinet reshuffle that is looming. Let me read for you this statement here that says, possible new faces in President William Ruto's looming cabinet changes. It proceeds to say that a cabinet reshuffle is looming, with fresh details indicating that President William Ruto could split the road transport, the road and transport docket to take care of competing political interest. So don't be shocked if you see Junet Mohammed being appointed by William Ruto as the cabinet secretary, because Junet Mohammed is already proving his loyalty to President William Ruto by defending President William Ruto's projects and is becoming too vocal about it. Number two, Junet Mohammed is already campaigning for President William Ruto ahead of the 2027 elections. That is exactly what Junet is doing, campaigning for President William Ruto's projects. That is why he's defending William Ruto. And number three, Junet Mohammed will lead the coalition between ODM and William Ruto's UDA party in the broad-based government. The same way Junet Mohammed led the campaigns in the Azimio coalition, it is going to happen in 2027. That is exactly what Junet is doing currently. I don't know what you think. I really want to know your thoughts and your opinion in the comment section down below. How can you describe Junet Mohammed? What can you say about Junet Mohammed defending President William Ruto? Please don't forget to subscribe to this channel for more political updates. Let me see you again in my next video analysis. Remember, my name is Jason. Bye-bye and have a good day.